glad that he's here. We've been saying that our goal is to get to mass market, to get to low-cost cars. We've gotten here as fast as we possibly can, and you know, with this car, the price of a five adults plus potentially two rear-facing child seats in the back, like the old station wagons. This will have a range. In terms of how we're addressing the range issue, this can have a range of up to 300 miles. The base version, to be clear, at $50,000 is a 160-mile range back. But one of the things we think we can possibly do is offer rental. So if people want to buy that 160-mile range pack, but then occasionally need a longer range, they can rent a 300-mile pack. We're also having a 45-minute charge capability, which is the limit of the battery chemistry. And we're designing a battery pack. It's in the full pan between the two axles. So it can be dropped down and switched out faster than you can fill a gas tank. Which stands to reason, if you think about it, like, think of this as sort of a giant laptop on wheels, just as you can switch out your laptop battery pack with the appropriate equipment, you can switch out this battery pack very quickly.
Hot swappable?
It is hot swappable. I mean, I don't know if you want to be in motion when it's happening, but that could be tricky. Anything's possible. This car would be somewhere around the 4,000 pound range. Oh, the battery pack. Well, it depends on which battery pack, but figure a little over 1,000 pounds, like 1,100 pounds or thereabouts. So it'd be about maybe just about 30% of the car mass, something like that. Big one. This will be the body panels and chassis are expected to be aluminum, although we may offer some carbon fiber options. But as one of the things in order to get the price as affordable as possible, the best combination of mass optimization and cost optimization is aluminum. And anyway, so we think we've done what needs to be done to address the range issue, the combination of 300-mile range, 45-minute charge, and a fast pack swap capability. And it's tremendous amount of cargo space, more cargo space than without any other sedan. And the ability to optionally put five adults, two kids, and then still have room in the front, which is also a triangle, to put luggage. Because the powertrain is all in the format. And with that, let me hand it over to Franz to talk about the design.
Yeah, I wonder how much work they've
done. Thanks, Elon. Franz, for those of you who don't know me, I've been with Tesla for about 7 months, which is when we started Model S in earnest, and it's beginning of Tesla design. Model S is intended to be the cornerstone of the foundation of the product for Tesla moving forward. So we're happy. I'm super excited to show the car to you guys. It's something that we've been working as a team hard on for the past months, and it has been a teamwork effort, not just from design, but from powertrain and everybody here at Tesla. The car, as you noticed, is about the size of maybe a Mercedes CLS or a BMW 5 Series, 7 Series, but it holds 7 people. And when I first got the brief from Elon that we needed to create a vehicle that held 7 people and had storage as well, I thought for sure we're not doing a sedan, because that's an SUV, basically, the SUV. But with this awesome powertrain situation, having a fully electric vehicle allows is to be able to create a vehicle like this, a sedan like this, with all that functionality, to great style, and also the awesome environmental impact. It's uncompromised, and that's
they started over.
Kind of best describes the vehicle. It's very athletic in its front, its impression on the road. The stance is great. There's room in the rear when the seats fold flat for a bicycle without the wheel to come off. That was kind of one of our parameters that we discussed. Also, in the back, we can put two baby seats for the 7 passengers. So it's just awesome. The interior has a flat floor across the rear, allows for 5 full-size adults in the back, and I think you'll all get an opportunity to experience that. We're also environmentally friendly on the interior. We're using vegetable tan leather. The carpeting on the car is made out of recycled PET bottles. We've got a 17-inch infotainment screen. It's the worst piece of technology that really allows us to communicate so much more to the user. So all that is wrapped up in a very aspirational package, and we think it's every bit as good as our competitive set of products, and hopefully you get that as well. With that, if there's any questions, I'll turn it back to Elon. But please enjoy the drive. We're going to do some hot laps in this thing, and enjoy it. Thanks.
All right, so just to calibrate people appropriately, this is, I think, a very sophisticated prototype, but it is a prototype. So you're expecting every last, it's not quite every last nuance correct, but there may be a few details here and there. So I think evaluate it as a prototype with the expectation that there'll be further refinements. In fact, France is never happy with the fine details of the design, and so you'll expect little improvements here and there in the design. Tweaks to improve the aerodynamic optimization. The interior interface is going to get a lot better. So when you look at the 17-inch display, you don't think, oh, that's what it's going to look like. That's one of the least advanced systems on the vehicle. It's getting the aesthetics and the user interface just perfect. But we're going to work on that to the point where it's every last detail is great. On the interior and exterior, you'll notice things like the shut line on the rear. We use a 4-bar linkage so that you'll see a constant gap all the way around the rear. It's not a sort of slam close, it comes down a 4-bar linkage, and there's no, you don't have to over slam. It sort of has that nice sort of cut line. We're expecting the same thing to be true for the whole vehicle, just really refined, fine panels and details on the interior. It sort of kills me when you have a product where it looks great from a distance, but then you come close to the details, there's a car, it's like the knobs don't feel quite right, so the stitching doesn't look right, and the little details that look cheap or don't work very well. Acknowledging the efficiency of the Roadster, it does have a few minor issues like that, which, by the way, we are improving with the Roadster Sport and the new versions that are coming out. But with the Model S, this is our Rev 2. And we're really going to make sure we get every little detail right. So we're going to be complete perfectionists about the body, the interior, the powertrain, the interface, all the little elements. This isn't going to be a car where you get in and after a while you start to have some issues. It's going to be where you actually zoom in and look at the tiny details that it's going to be just right. And on the rear, in the rear area, one compromise we made on this prototype is that the actual production version will have the motor rotated flat behind the rear axle. This one, we didn't have quite much time to do that, so the motor is slightly inclined, which reduces the rear trunk area. But the rear trunk will actually be about 2 inches lower than what it is here. So it'll actually drop down about 2 inches and be completely flat across the thing. So there actually is a lot more room there for two rear-facing kit seats than you might think. I should also mention from a safety standpoint that the car is being designed to a 5-star crash radar. And that is actually very difficult. Today's a 5-star crash radar that's being produced today is equivalent to a 3-star in 2 years. So that bar keeps getting raised. And so it's actually quite difficult to achieve that. But 5-star minimum, including safety for the rear child seats, is going to be it is a requirement. So this is going to be a very safe car. The center of gravity is extremely low because the battery packs in the floor pan, so you don't have the rollover risk that you might have with an SUV. We want to make something that is actually safer than an SUV, that is actually more functional than an SUV. I think if you're trying to put a surfboard, a 50-inch TV, and a mountain bike in an SUV, you have a lot of problems. That's actually very difficult. You can't with this car with the resistance holding forward. So we're really trying to make something which is, you have your cake and you need it too. And then this is also designed as a platform. People also value and understand design things to be a platform for extensibility. So you can think of the powertrain as kind of a skate between these two wheels, and we can put different top hats on that. So down the road, for future models, we can extend it to become a crossover SUV or a next generation roadster, a utility van. There's a lot of extensibility to this platform. So that's the main items. So happy to take questions. Actually, we have one question. So profitability in the third quarter of this year, which is not bad given the external economic circumstances that we face. We're not far from the third quarter, so you know, I'm saying this with a very high degree of confidence. It's looking good on that front, but that doesn't give us the cash needed for the markets. There's the problem energy bug that people may have heard about. I can say I'm 99% confident we will get that, and that it will happen in the short term. If it doesn't, I'm personally standing behind any deposits that are going to happen. So the circumstances where you lose your deposit, there is a corner case. If you put down a deposit in the car, which gets you a home production slot, the circumstances where you lose the deposit is if my net worth goes to zero. Tesla goes direct, but my net worth goes to zero. And my future earning potential is also not enough to compensate for the deposits.
With the mountain roads and
how
the battery range will do with the mountain
roads. Actually, the battery range does quite well in the mountains. There was recently a truck that went on the rally in Monte Carlo, which is actually over the Alps and up and down hills and everything. It actually just recently set up for European record for EV range. It did a 240 mile circuit through the mountains and had 48 miles left to go at an average speed of 38 miles. It actually made all the European newspapers.
Will it have power of the mountain road?
Oh yeah, absolutely. You will be able to all have speed on the road.